About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock. And our program this evening is about our annual match show. And that is coming up very shortly, like this Sunday. The match show is going to be at the 4-H Community Center, but I'll let our show chairman, our match show chairman, give you more information about what a match show is and where it is and, you know, the particulars. So my guests this evening are Al Staudt, and he is our match show chairman. And next to him with the little black fuzzball is Linda Madeira, and she is our obedience chairman. And to the left of me, I have Diane Ondo with a Cairn Terrier, and she is one of our judges. And the last one with the little black miniature poodle is Pearl Wanner. So we're going to talk to Al first. So Al, suppose you tell us what a match show actually is.
Okay, a match show is a show, basically it is a point show, but it carries no points.
Okay.
Usually a lot of people bring out their puppies to get them acclimated, get them ready for the shows. The point show's coming up, you know, within the next couple of months. This year we're offering confirmation, junior showmanship, and obedience.
And this is like a practice then?
It really is.
Okay.
The only difference between this and a point show, other than it carrying no points, is we can have puppies entered 3 months of age.
Okay, okay.
And AKC point shows, you must be 6 months of age.
Right, okay. Well, there is another difference, though. With the match show, the dogs are shown in numerical order, not numerical, alphabetical order. Oh, alphabetical order.
Correct. They are
in
done.
Different groups. Right,
right. They are done by groups and then alphabetical breeding.
Okay, so you don't know. If you're looking for a particular breed, like if I wanted to say, look at Doberman Pinschers, mm-hmm. You wouldn't be able to tell me when they were going to be on, correct?
No, because they would probably be following, like the Akita, Alaskan Malamute, and then on down.
Right, right.
And then there are some times where we may not get your common breeds like your Doberman, Great Dane, St. Bernards.
Yeah, it's whoever enters.
Right.
And you can enter that day, right?
Yes.
Okay, okay, okay. So then what time does it start?
Registration starts at 8 o'clock.
Okay.
Judging will start with junior showmanship at 9 o'clock.
Okay. And then the regular breed judging is
right after.
Probably about 9:15, 9:30, okay. Somewhere around there.
All right. So it's a match show then is sort of a little more laid back.
It's a very informal dog show.
Okay, okay. Because with a point show, everything is, you know, strictly on time. Here we go.
Right.
This is what's going where.
Right.
And,
you
and
have
how
guidelines.
Many, right, that's exactly
that
right.
And
with a
match
show, it's like, you know, whoever shows up is who shows.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that simple. But we usually have a fair amount of dogs that show up.
Yes, we range anywhere from 80 to 1 year we had up to 140 some.
I thought we had 150 one year.
Yeah.
So I guess it depends whether, who knows? So the weather, if it's a nice day or if it's a rainy day, who knows? You know, if it's rainy and people don't have anything else to do, or if it's a nice day and they want to come because it is a nice day and get their puppies out. You just never know. There is pre-entry, though, right?
Yes, and unfortunately that closes tomorrow.
Oh, okay. Well, if you wanted to pre-enter, you'd really have to rush.
Right.
How much is it to enter?
It's $10
okay.
Per dog, or like in obedience. It's also $10, but they can go through the course as many times as they want. But each time they run, they must pay the $10.
Okay, okay.
But only one score counts.
Okay, so in confirmation, then, you get a once and done.
That's correct.
Okay, okay. Now, how are the classes, before we get into that, you want to tell them where it is. It's at the 4-H Community Center, in case Some of you don't know where that is. It's near the Reading Fairgrounds. But what's the address in case they want to put it on their GPS to find it?
Okay, their address is 1238 County Welfare Road. That's Reading. I thought it was Leesport, but it's 19533.
Yeah, that is Leesport. That's a Leesport.
It's a Leesport.
It is Leesport. Yeah. Right. So this is, it's basically across the street from the old Burke's Heim, or
which
before
isn't there anymore.
Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The building's gone.
It's gone.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. It used to be there. It used to be there, but now it's just nothing. Mm-hmm. But the new Burke's Heim, you'd pass the 4-H before you got to the new Burke's Heim. It's right behind the Agricultural Center. If you go past the building that has a big cow in the window, the second floor window, that's the agricultural building. So it's behind there. So pull into that parking lot and go behind the building, and that's where it is. But you'll see cars parked there. You know, their cars are going to be parked all over the place. So, and it's free parking, right?
Yes.
Is it anything to get in to watch?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. And it's spectators
free.
Are encouraged.
Very good.
To attend.
Yeah, we like the people to come because a lot of times there is a lot of puppies that are being shown. And we want the puppies to realize that people are nice things. You know, it doesn't hurt to be touched by a person. And usually the owner will hand you a cookie and say, here, give this to the puppy so that they like you, so they're getting used to you. And that's basically what a mat show is. We want the puppies to be comfortable. This may be, the dog may be showing all the way to its, what is it, platinum gold championship, grand champion. They have different levels of grand champion, and that this dog may be shown for the next 5-6 years. And if the dog doesn't enjoy it as a puppy, it's not going to show well as an adult. So that's why we do this. And of course, you can come and see the puppies and play with them. Well, sort of play with them. After they come out of the ring, you can play with them. So the classes, now that we know where it is, the classes.
Classes we're offering is puppies 3 to 6, 6 mm-hmm. to 9, and 9 to 12.
Okay.
And we're also offering adults, which are 12 to 18 months, and the open class, which is anything over 18 months of age.
Okay. Now, I understand the puppy classes, but why would you be showing an adult?
Keep it ready for the shows.
Just getting ready for the show. An so inexperienced far, handler
inexperienced
wants
dog.
To get familiar with his dog as to how to show the dog.
Okay.
It's very laid back. Usually the judges will help an inexperienced exhibitor.
Okay.
With it as compared to going to a point show mm-hmm. where the judge goes over your dog, sends you out the ring.
Okay. So maybe a person who had a dog that was being shown by the handler, and they might have decided they're going to show it themselves
now?
What about a champion? If you have a like in that situation, if my dog was a champion, but a handler had finished the mm-hmm. dog, and now I want to show it to its grand championship in the best of breed classes?
You can. You would be able to enter it at the match, but for exhibition only.
Okay. Well, yeah, that's understandable. It's already a champion. But it would give me the experience.
Correct.
Okay.
And it's just a leisurely afternoon with your dog.
Mm-hmm. And we do have food, right?
Yes, we have wonderful food starting, I guess, at 9 o'clock for breakfast.
Okay.
Up until, I would imagine, 1, 2 o'clock.
8 o'clock for breakfast.
All homemade. Everything is homemade by the members. We all made the food, are making the food. So it's all homemade and it's very inexpensive and we have a whole gamut. I mean, we have egg sandwiches for breakfast and we have barbecue and hamburgers and hot dogs and chili and soups for lunch and we have desserts. And
No hamburgers, but barbecue.
Barbecue. No hamburgers, but barbecue. Barbecue. Sorry, made a mistake
hot
there.
Hot dogs.
Yeah.
Soups, lots of soups.
Yeah, lots of soups, right.
Desserts,
right.
Desserts, good
desserts. So now, this is judged just like a regular point show, right?
That's correct.
Okay, so there's going to be rings set up and matting and the whole bit. You're going to go and see it like it's a real live dog show. And
correct.
It's inside. It's indoors, so if it rains, it doesn't really matter because we're inside. Mm-hmm. So it's all set up like a regular
point
show.
Point show.
Okay,
correct.
And you have a judge.
We have a judge.
Lots of judges.
We have a steward.
Okay.
The steward will call the class or the dogs in. Judge will go over them.
Do you wear a number?
Yep. Pick up your armband.
Okay.
The steward will call you in. You will be judged. Get your ribbon if you're uh-huh. lucky enough.
Uh-huh.
And then wait for groups which immediately follow, and then best in match.
Okay. Yeah.
We also have a raffle table.
Oh, yeah.
Lots of raffle
prep. That's right.
Raffle baskets.
Yeah, we do. We do have a raffle table. And
lots of raffle tables.
We have a lot of raffle baskets. And, of course, they're all dog oriented. You know, it's a dog show. We have all dog stuff, toys and sweaters. And they're beautiful baskets, really beautiful baskets. I think last year we had 62 of them. So, you know,
almost everybody went home with a basket.
Yeah, almost everybody went home with at least one basket.
At least one.
But anyhow, so where do the judges come from? Where do you collect these judges from?
Well, this year they're all my friends.
Okay. but this he's not showing, so it doesn't matter.
This is really a stepping stone for a lot of judges who want to go for their AKC license.
Okay.
They must judge, I guess, 3 or 4 matches to be eligible to apply for their license through American
okay.
Kennel Club.
Okay. So then the judges are getting experience as well. Correct. As the people showing the dogs and the dogs. So, I mean, it's everybody's yeah. getting experience here. This is a learning for everybody. Are we going to have any vendors? Sometimes we have vendors. Is there anybody coming with leashes and toys?
I'm not aware of any.
Okay.
I don't think we are this year.
Okay.
But they may show up at the last minute.
Okay. But I know we have pictures. There are pictures being taken.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So even if you wanted a picture taken with your dog, even if you're not entered, you can come and have a picture taken with your dog. Make sure the dog's under control and on a leash, of course. But that's, you know, something else that you can do. We don't invite dogs that aren't entered, mainly because it gets crowded. It's just that simple. And if your dog is not used to that atmosphere, they may get a little reactive or a little upset. If you are going to be bringing your own dog, do not let it run up to another dog. The people who are showing their dogs will not appreciate that, especially if they're ready to go in the ring. So it's best to leave your own dog at home, unless you're planning on having a picture taken, but leave your own dog at home. It'll be much more enjoyable. You won't have to worry about the dog. And you can eat lunch and not have your dog trying to take the food out of your mouth. So, you know, it's a much more enjoyable day if your little guy stays home. What else do I want to cover here? Let me see. Ask about petting the dogs before you do. Some dogs, especially if you're bringing the kids, some dogs are not child friendly. It's not that they're not child friendly. I don't know what they are.
Not a socializer.
You know, they're not. These are not. They don't consider them little humans. And especially if the kid screams and goes trying to run up to them, you know, dogs are going to get startled. It's the same as we are. So please ask before your child tries to pet the dog. Remember, these are dogs that are getting used to this environment. So, you know, use a little common sense, the kids are welcome, definitely. The kids are welcome to see, you know, the dogs. What kid doesn't like a dog? So suppose we talk a little bit about obedience. I think all of our puppies, except for the little Cairn, are falling asleep. I guess we're going to
mine's sound asleep.
Yeah. Yeah, yours is done in.
She's done in. She's falling up.
Yeah,
if I let go, she's going to fall up.
So obedience starts when then? Oh, before we get to obedience, let's take a break first. Come right back.
Okay.
You're watching All About Dogs on bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other stories about animals and pets, go to www.bctv.org. All About Dogs is underwritten by the Berks County Kennel Club and by Berks Dog Training Club. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
We're back. Okay, Linda's going to tell us a little bit about our obedience classes, and that starts at what time, Linda?
Well, hopefully we're going to start around noon.
Okay.
We don't start until after the breed showing is over.
Okay. Well, we use the same rings.
We use the same rings, so we got to make sure they're done first. And then immediately after the breed rings, a breed is done, then we'll set up for obedience.
Okay. We
have to get the jumps out and everything and get them ready. And change judges and change stewards.
Right.
And then we're going to have four classes.
Yeah.
We have beginners, novice, we have novice, we have open and utility.
Okay.
The open and utility is going to be in one ring by the same judge.
Uh-huh.
And then I drafted some of the judges from the Berks County Dog Training Club. And one of the other girls I met at a dog show and was watching her show, and she did very well. So I asked her if she wanted to judge novice class.
Mm-hmm.
So
Good.
We're going to have somebody who is different, somebody who's not a member of the dog training club. But
so then we'll see all ranges from the very, very start to
the
highest level of obedience.
Yep. Some of the people from our basic skills class and our beginners class at the dog training club will probably enter.
Mm-hmm,
we've been handing out flyers and encouraging them to enter, to give it a try.
Right, right.
Because this is where you start in a match. You don't want to go to a point show and spend $30 and discover your dog doesn't know a thing.
Right. That's exactly right.
Or freaks out or gets in a ring and gets panicky.
Yeah. Now, in beginner novice, everything is done on leash.
Everything except for the recall.
Right, okay.
The recall is done
off leash. The recall is done off leash. A recall is calling your dog to come to you.
Yep.
That's what a recall is.
Yep. And every dog should come when they're called.
Right.
Even
right.
if they're not a show dog.
Right.
You know, or
yeah, well,
dog. Every dog.
The obedience isn't really necessarily just for show dogs.
Yep. Where
of course, they're show dogs because they're going to a show.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not necessarily dogs that are going to go into the breed ring.
Mm-hmm.
Dogs that, for one reason or another, aren't quite up to the standard for the breed ring. You know, you may not even be interested in that. So you buy a nice pet and you have it neutered and you don't know what to do. This is what you do. You go into obedience.
Mm-hmm.
Every dog should know obedience. This is, you know, you want to live with the dog in your house.
Even so, mixed breeds can be in obedience.
Right.
They will allow
you. We're having mixed breeds as well.
In obedience,
yes, okay.
Yes, we are.
Okay, mixed breeds can enter as well in the show. So, but that will be starting around noontime. So if you want to see what obedience is all about, or if you have some questions, hey, come on out and watch. Somebody's going to be there to answer any question you have. Just grab somebody walking by, and they'll be able to answer all the questions. I'll be there all day long, so will Al, so will Linda. Diane will probably be there all day long, and so will Pearl. So you know each of us, so grab one of us. We'll be able to answer your questions.
Hopefully.
Yeah. What do you mean, hopefully? Of course we'll be able to answer your questions. Even if it isn't the correct answer, we'll answer your question.
Mm-hmm.
How about we see some of the dogs, though? Because that's what the point of the match show is about, the dogs. So how about we start with Diane and her Cairn Terrier? I suppose you tell us a little bit about your girl.
Okay, this is Miss Megan, and she has not started yet, but she will be. She's
okay.
She's 11 months old, so
okay.
She's still considered a puppy.
Yep.
Stop. This table's wagging. This, as everybody would know, would be Toto from The Wizard of Oz. That's her only claim to fame.
Does she have a tail?
Yeah, she does.
Oh, yeah. There it
she
is.
Has a little tail. This is a double-coated terrier from the Isle of Skye in Scotland, was used to go into the ground and worry out the groundhogs, the weasels, whatever was eating the farmer's crop. And what they used to do was dig in there and worry them out so the farmer could kill them.
And that's what go to ground means, right?
Yep.
They go
this
right
is
into
a
the
digger
hole.
Dog,
yep.
So if you have your garden or nice lawn and you don't want it dug up by the squirrels or the chipmunks in your backyard and the rabbits, you don't want a Cairn Terrier.
Yep, that's exactly right.
But if you wanted a nice alert barker, somebody that can do whatever you want, run miles, walk, take walks, or sit around and watch TV all night, you might be interested in
and
this
And they're good
terrier.
With kids, too, right?
Oh, they're very hardy with kids. Older kids, school-age
yeah.
children.
Yeah, yeah, but they
know.
Can, especially if you have boys, because they,
boys.
They will play all day long with you.
Yeah, these are very hardy dogs.
Uh-huh.
You can't hurt these things. They're very hardy.
Okay, now what color is she?
She is what we call a black to brown brindle. As you see, there's very brindling in her coat. Cairn Terrier cannot be solid black. Like this poodle that you'll see is solid black. These guys would never be that color.
Okay, when you're saying brindling, what do you
It means there's a mixture of colors in her coat. There's all the way from black to brown to red to cream.
Gray. Yeah.
To gray to silver. Yep, there's a lot of brindling on this dog.
It's a multicolored dog.
Yep, they're all that way. It all depends on the...
Okay, but they come in other colors as well,
Anything but white.
Oh, okay.
You can have anything. There shouldn't be any white on these guys. Not whatsoever. It's the West Highland White Terrier, which these guys created. Because what happened was the farmers come dusk would probably mistake this dog for a groundhog with her coloring, and they'd shoot them by mistake. So the farmers took the lighter dogs, kept breeding them until they got white, and that breed became separate. Oh, it's been probably a couple hundred years now, but so that's why these guys can't be white.
Okay. All right. Okay, very good.
We know they're hardy because Pat went and whacked it with a table and it never
even move. She didn't care.
She bumped it with a table.
All right, Pearl, how about we see the poodle?
Okay. If I have enough of cord to reach.
Does cord reach? I think so. Mm-hmm. We don't want you to fall over the microphone here. You got it.
I'm going to put it up over?
Yeah, just put it on Diane's head. That's right.
There you go.
Okay.
Like she had, like Pat had said, this is the miniature poodle puppy.
How old is she?
Now this puppy here will be 12 weeks old. He's 11 weeks old right now. His color is black, and Diane's had made mention about their colors. Poodles can come in basically. AKC recognizes for the confirmation ring any solid color. Black, solid white, solid brown. And there's varying light and dark shades of that. Now they're probably, if you look around hard enough, you will even see some poodles that are what we call party color. That's when there are blotches of different colors within this.
And frequently you'll see a white one with black spots on.
Yes.
And sometimes a black one with brown, like, almost like a Doberman, like with the brown above the eyes and, you know, brown feet. But that's not recognized by the American Kennel Club? You can't show those?
The parent club, meaning the Poodle Club of America, has now instituted at the national show. They may be shown in specific classes just for the colors alone.
Oh,
before, some of the party colors would show up and go through the Parade of Champions.
Uh-huh.
And the AKC recognized solid color. Those breeders didn't particularly care for that.
Uh-huh.
So they have instituted a class just for the party color.
Okay, but this is only the Poodle Club of America.
Yes.
Okay, all righty.
Yes. And now this is, I'm going to say, this is the first time this puppy has really been out of the house. And I'm very pleased how he's standing here, very nice, and what we're calling this pose is being stacked. And
this is how you would show them, this is how you're going to show them on Sunday.
You would get them ready, prep them like this at the mat show,
And that's how they're shown as a regular. That's how they're shown as a regular show as well.
So I would say sometimes, even with a lot of these purebred dogs here, a lot of this is done instinctually.
Mm-hmm.
It comes through with a very smart parents, both the sire and the dam.
Okay. Now he's already shaved, right?
I actually prepped him, bathed him, and fluffed him, fluffed his hair up.
Uh-huh.
Then I took a clipper and shaved his face, feet, the tail, and the belly only.
Okay.
And I did some scissoring here.
Okay.
For the mat show eventually, as he progresses and his hair gets longer, I will begin to style him.
Okay.
Leave more hair here.
Uh-huh.
To create that nice, big, fluffy puppy cut.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he turns 1 year of age, then the coat pattern changes.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe you've seen them where their legs are shaved halfway down and there's a big ball of fur at the bottom of each leg. And then the hair is pulled up very tight up here, and what we call a big top knot.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some of them, it looks like they're so tight that, you know, you're pulling the eyeballs out.
Yes.
Okay, very good. All right, how about we put the Belgian on the table here?
Okay. Okay, Belgians are not typically shown on a table.
No, but we wanted to show him on the table because it's easier to see him.
It's a her.
Than on the her.
Her.
Than on the dark floor. That one was a, the black
that was,
poodle.
Yeah, that was her.
Was a him.
Okay, she's a little shaky.
She is not used to being on
a table because she's shown on the ground.
Nor would she be shown on the table. You'd need an awfully big table.
Yes, you would. And you need a very strong person to lift them up because
yes, because they go about 50, 60 pounds.
50, 60 pounds, yep.
So even when they're groomed, they're... You teach them to hop up on the table by themselves because they're a little too heavy to lift.
A little too heavy to lift.
But now, the Belgians only come in one color as well, right?
It's all black.
All black.
They can have a little bit of white on their chest or in their face.
Okay.
Or their back toes.
Okay.
And no more than 2 square inches on the chest.
Okay, okay.
And
and they need the stand-up ears, right?
They need stand-up ears.
Okay.
Yeah, but
she's looking at you.
Look at me. Somebody else.
Yeah, look out that way.
Look out that way.
Mm-hmm. Now, there are other varieties of this breed as well, right?
Yes, there's a Belgian Tervuren,
okay.
which is brown, which is what Pat has.
Uh-huh.
I have a couple of them, too. And there's a Malinois, which is a short-coated version.
Yeah, and that's usually what the police have now instead of the German Shepherds.
Mm-hmm.
And armed services.
Yes.
And they just recognize the Lacanois, right?
Yes, I've seen a couple of them now.
Okay,
I've been breeding these for 40-some years, and I've seen my first Lacanois this year.
Oh, really?
So.
Oh. The Lacanois have curly hair.
Yes.
It's very, it almost looks like an Airedale, doesn't it?
It does. I did recognize it as a Belgian.
Uh-huh.
But I knew what I've seen pictures, so I knew what I was looking for.
Right, right. Well, the Airedale has the
saddle.
Ear,
yeah, the
right,
saddle
whereas
ear,
the Belgian Lacanois has the, so if you're interested in a different looking breed, the Lacanois is definitely a choice. These dogs are very smart.
Yes.
They're all very, very intelligent. So
and very soft. I mean, not just fiber-wise, but they're
not
very
just petting-wise.
They're very sensitive, so they don't need harsh training. In fact, if you do harsh training, you won't get a very good, well-trained dog. They'll shut down on you.
Yeah.
They're very companion-oriented. They love to be with you, and they're very easy to train.
Yes, they are.
And, I get
as long as you don't mind doing coat.
Yes. And I do
don't mind brushing.
The black ones do not shed as much as the brown ones. I know that for a fact because I got some brown ones down. They shed 3 times more.
Yeah. Okay. But good. So our match show is this Sunday. It's at the 4-H Community Center. If you have any questions, you can call the Berks County Kennel Club. The telephone number will be at the end of the program. But it starts about 9:30 in the morning, 9:30 in the morning. And first is junior showmanship, and Diane will be judging that. And those are for children from what ages?
They start at 8.
8 years old, from 8 to 18,
18.
Right? 8
yep.
to 18. So you'll be able to see juniors in case your child happens to be interested in showing a dog or thinks they might like to do it. So you can watch juniors, which will be starting at 9 o'clock. Mm-hmm. Regular show shortly after that, and then obedience at noontime. So you can stay all day long, you can have lunch, and it's going to be a beautiful day. So we'll see you this Sunday, April the 6th, at the 4-H Community Center. So for this evening, good night.
Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.